Welcome back to ELA. Today we are going to be taking a look at another fascinating couple that we learned about in our Escaping to Freedom article, William and Ellen Craft. Remember, that was the couple, the woman Ellen, she dressed up as a rich white man and her husband pretended to be her slave. So I am going to read this article with some more information, some more details about Ellen and William Craft. Then you guys will reread on your own and answer your Google form questions. Okay, William and Ellen Craft. For sheer creativity and daring, few slaves' escapes can match the 1848 getaway masterminded by William and Ellen Craft. The two had married in Macon, Georgia in 1846, but were held in slavery by different masters. Oh wow, so they were married, but they were owned by different slave masters. Terrified of being separated, they devised an ingenious plan to flee the Deep South for Philadelphia. So because they were so worried that one of them could be sold, and they would be separated, they came up with a really smart plan to escape to Philadelphia. The light-skinned Ellen cut her hair short, dressed herself in men's clothing, and wrapped her head in bandages to pose as an injured white man. Wow, so because her skin was light, she was able to dress up and wrap her head up and pretend to be an injured rich white man. William, meanwhile, assumed the role of her loyal black manservant, so her slave. On December 21st, 1848, the Crafts wore their disguises and boarded a train to begin the long journey north. Their plan seemed doomed from the very start, after Ellen found herself sitting next to a close friend of her master. But her elaborate costume prevented her from being recognized. Oh my gosh, what are the odds? The day they decide to escape, they get on the train and Ellen is sitting next to one of the best friends of her master. Luckily, she must have had a really good disguise because he didn't recognize her. The Crafts spent the next several days traveling by train and steamer, that's a ship, through the South, lodging in fine hotels, and rubbing elbows with upper-class whites to maintain their cover. Since she could not read or write, Ellen placed her arm in a sling to avoid signing tickets and papers. So she didn't know how to read or write, so she put her arm in a sling. She acted like her arm was injured so that she wouldn't have to use it. But she was nearly found out when a Charleston steamer clerk refused to sell the pair their tickets without a signature. Oh, so one of the people selling tickets said, "I'm sorry, I cannot sell you this ticket without a signature." Luckily for the Crafts, the captain of their previous ship happened to pass by and agreed to sign for her. Wow, they got really lucky again. The Crafts arrived in Philadelphia on Christmas Day and were sheltered by abolitionists before continuing on to Boston. So another group of abolitionists helped the Crafts, just like an abolitionist helped Henry Box Brown. Fearing slave hunters, the couple later set sail for England, where they wrote a popular account of their escape and raised a family. Oh wow, so they went to England too, just like Henry Box Brown did. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed that super interesting story. Reread it on your own and answer your questions. All right, good job.